Can you imagine a world without this? Or where this is a thing of the past? Before 1937, this was a real possibility, since many species were driven to near extinction. But thanks to wildlife restoration funding, we can enjoy a world where wildlife is plentiful and the hunt is still a pastime that you and I can enjoy here in South Carolina. The Federal Aid in Wildlife Restoration Act of 1937, more commonly known as the Pittman-Robertson Act, places an excise tax on firearms, ammunition, and archery equipment that provides funds to each state to manage animals and their habitats. Since 1937, over $10 billion from the Wildlife Restoration Act has been distributed to state wildlife agencies like our Department of Natural Resources to aid in habitat protection, wildlife restoration, and hunter education. In South Carolina, the impact has been extraordinary. In 1900, white-tailed deer numbers were as low as 20,000. Thanks to restoration efforts funded through wildlife restoration dollars, the statewide deer population today is approximately 750,000. In the 1950s, the wild turkey population was limited to a few counties. Over 4,000 birds were trapped and restocked in the decades since, and now turkeys are present in all 46 counties in South Carolina. Other programs that have been funded through wildlife restoration include the Wood Duck Box Program and, more recently, the South Carolina Bobwhite Initiative. Wildlife restoration dollars are also used to provide public hunting opportunities on over 1 million acres of land through the state's Wildlife Management Area Program. Another major component of the Wildlife Restoration Act is providing funds for hunter education classes and shooting sports programs like the National Archery in the Schools program and Scholastic Clay Target Sports. The outdoor opportunities that many in South Carolina enjoy can be traced back to the Wildlife Restoration Act of 1937. And the Department of Natural Resources is committed to the success and growth of the programs that will keep the hunting heritage legacy alive in South Carolina.